Hello everyone and welcome back to the session on Google Forms as a part of 2-week workshop on From E-Learning to E-Training, a comprehensive guide for all your administrative work. Friends, in the previous video, we have studied about Google Forms. It was an introductory video on Google Forms where we studied about the uses and the attributes of the Google Forms. We learnt about what are the uses of Google Forms and why do we choose them over other options. So in today's video, we are going to start with creating a new Google Form. It's a hands-on training video on Google Forms. So let's try creating a new Google Form. For creating a new Google Form, all you need is a Gmail account. You sign in into your Gmail account and at this window at the top right hand side corner, you will see this button Google Apps. Click on this button and then click on Google Drive. So Drive is a place where all your documents, where all your spreadsheets, slides are stored. So basically in this Google Drive, so the documents that you have created and the documents which is being shared by others with you are stored here. So to create a Google Form, we'll click on this button New. Once you click on this button, it will ask you whether you want to upload a file or a folder, you want to create these documents or whatever. The option of Google Forms is there under the More tab. At this page only, there is also another option like Add This button. My Drive, there is a drop down arrow. You click on this, it will ask you the same information again, and you click on More and then you click on Google Forms. Once you click on Google Forms, a new window will be opened and your blank Google Form will look like this. This is your untitled blank Google Form. There is another way also to create a Google Form. Say in a new tab, you just typed Google Forms and you open this web page of Google Forms. You will see here two options, personal account or a business account. Since we are using a personal account, I'll click this option under the personal, go to Google Forms. Once I click on this option, it will redirect me to the page where I can see or where it is asking me, where do you want to start from? With a blank form, or you want to use any of the templates which are available already in the Google Forms gallery. At the same time, it is showing me the list of recent forms that I have created using Google Forms. So to start with a blank form, I'll click here, start a new form. You can see here it is showing me the same interface, untitled form, blank form. There is another way also to create Google Forms through Google Sheets. So you open a Google Sheet. When you are opening a Google Sheet, you will see a blank sheet here and there are various tabs at the top of this blank sheet. So once it is loaded, you click on the option Tools. Yes, now it is ready to work. We can start working on it. So click on the option Tools. And the very first option which is shown here is Create a Form. Click on this option, Create a Form. It will redirect you to the new window where you can see a new Google Form is being created. This Google Form will also have the same interface as the other Google Forms. The only difference is that it is showing here spreadsheet and here it is showing here as form. This is because it is being created using a spreadsheet, that's why spreadsheet, but that is not a problem. You can remove this, you can change the name as per your convenience, whatever you want. So friends, these are the three ways through which you can create a Google Form. So now let's try making a Google Form with questions. Let's say in my college, I want to collect some data for NAC maybe regarding the research and publication profiles of the faculty members. So, research and publications profile. I can give here the form description, that is the explanation, any kind of disclaimer or any sort of description that I want to give, I can mention here. So, let's say I can write here the information collected through this form will be used solely for the purpose of NAC, right? So this is the description that I have given. Now I can give this file a title. If I click on it, it will automatically lift my form title as this file title. I can change the name. Let's say faculty. I can write faculties research and publication profile, because you know, in NAC there are different sort of information which is required. Some information from faculty, some information from administrative staff, some information from students. So just to make it convenient for me to locate and to access, I have given this as a title, faculty's research and publications profile. Okay, now you can see here, whatever I'm doing, all the changes are saved automatically. I need not to press any save button or I need not to refresh my window. It is being saved automatically. So now let's start with the questions. Let's say the first question, obviously I'll ask them, is their name. So I can write here faculty name. So I can mention here it as a short answer text, or if I want a long answer text, I can use paragraph as a question type. So whatever is you're convenient with, you can use that. To add a next question, I'll click on this button plus. From this button, the next question can be created. Let's say I want to ask them their email addresses. So Google knows that email addresses are generally short in nature. So it has automatically chosen the question type as short answer. Next, I can ask them department to which they belong, right? So department, it can be a short answer text because people just have to write mathematics, economics, commerce, sociology, psychology, history, whatever it is, and the department to which they belong. Next question, let's say I want to ask if they have published any research papers. So I can ask them, have you published any research paper / article in the last 5 years? Yes. Okay. So now Google is very smart and is giving me these options. Yes, no, maybe. So because I'm asking them whether they have published or not, I can choose these options directly from here. Yes, no. I have not chosen option maybe here because I am straight away asking faculty members whether they have published or not. So they can give me the answer in yes or no. Next question, I can ask them, say whether the article, okay, I'll use the same language, paper or article is published in a refereed journal. Okay, now again it is giving me those options, yes, no, maybe. If I want to add all, I can just click on this add all and all the three options would be added. If the journal is referred, the faculty member can choose yes, otherwise no. And if they don't know, then they can choose maybe. So it's your choice whether you want to give them all the three options or it's better to manage with two options, yes or no. Okay, next question I can ask them, list the title of your paper or papers, because there could be more than one paper. So in the last 5 years, if the faculty has published more than one paper, so definitely they'll be needing more space to write down. So I'll choose paragraph as my question type. Paragraph. So this is all in my sample form. I can ask them these informations, and obviously I can preview my form before sending it over to the recipients. So I can click on this I button, which can show me the preview of my form. So my form will look like this, and I can also test it or verify it whether the questions are framed correctly and the information which I am expecting from recipients, whether they would be able to give me in a proper and correct format or not. So let's try this. So let's try filling out the form. Faculty name I have put in, and any random email address. Department, let's say economics. Okay, next question is, have you published any research paper or article in the last 5 years? Yes. Is it in the refereed journal? Yes. List the title of your papers. Okay, so let me list. So first paper, let's say, is migration matters, then digital intelligence. I have economic development and policies as another paper. So that is the list. It can go on increasing, right? Okay, so now I have seen and observed that the information can be filled out correctly. Then I can also try submitting it. So now you can see that the submission is also possible and the response has been recorded. This message is being displayed by Google Forms itself, that the person who has submitted the response, the person has got this message that the response has been recorded. Now, if you see in this window where you originally created your Google form, you see here in the response section, I have got one response, which is the same response which I filled here just now. So within the seconds, or actually within the fractions of seconds, the information has got updated. This is the real-time updation. So this person has filled in the form with all this information, right? So this is the response sheet. So friends, this is all in this video about creating a Google form.